So we have our next problem when the quadrant of, we want to know the quadrant of theta when cosecant is positive and cotangent is negative. So cosecant, that's 1 over sine is positive, and of course sine is the y value. Now, if the reciprocal 1 over y is positive, that's the same as saying that y is positive. All right, so right away, we have narrowed it down pretty quick. Y is positive, so it's definitely 1 or 2. 3 and 4 are out, so I'm going to put some red X's down there. All right, cotangent. Cotangent, similar to tangents, the reciprocal. So it's X over Y, and this quotient is negative. So there's two possibilities to make a quotient negative. X is negative, and y is positive, or x is positive and y is negative. All right, which of these is occurring? Well, I took care of the cosecant first because I could immediately narrow it down to y being positive. So y being positive is what's happening, which means y cannot be negative. So we're crossing out this possibility and we're left with only x is negative and y is positive. So x is negative puts us in quadrant 2. So our answer is quadrant 2, or if you're in Roman numerals, you do the II.